first drone went into the water. You can see that on a previous video. So when I fly with the Phantom above water, I always get a strange feeling. And I'm a little bit scared of flying above the water. So I was looking on the internet, and then they made all kinds of floaters for the legs, the landing gear of the DJI Phantom. And so we went to the store and we buy two types of, this is for the water pipe insulation, two types. This one can fits in that one, and then I made the ends, I put something in here that the water cannot come into this. One of the floaters is already done, and what you need to do further, what you need to buy is these, if you can get them. These are pretty new. I didn't see them before, but today in the I saw them in the shop and I thought, hey, this is perfect for this. And then 28 tie wraps, measuring tape, utility knife, and a
cutter.
A cutter. And some duct tape. And you need a good quality duct tape. And two knitting needles. So I start with cutting this one, and I made it a certain length because everyone thinks, when you see those videos, everyone thinks that because the gimbal is on the front side of the drone, that would be the heaviest part of the drone. But I show you, because of the heavy battery, when I pick it up in the middle, he is hanging backwards, slightly backwards, you see? So I'm gonna make this not in the middle, but a little to the back, that he floats better on the back than on the front. And you should say that if you make them longer, so like this, then it will float better. But then you see with the camera, you see all this in your video that you are making. And now I'm bending it, this one, and that one too, that he is stable, so that he cannot go far over or backwards. Well, I measured this one 10 inch, so I'm gonna cut 10 inch of this material. So, and then this one fits in here. So you measure this piece and that 1.5 inch. So the pipe was, that one was 10 inch, 2 times 1.5 is 13 inch length. Then you cut this one open. There's this price tag. The total cost was about, yeah, the duct tape. I cannot add the duct tape with it because I use a little of this, but it's under 10 euros. So material. This one in here. And then I put a tie wrap. So way to the right, so like this. A tie wrap. And this piece was 2 inch, so I'm gonna cut it 2 inch. And this is all the first time that I made it, so we have to see if it floats. I hope it floats. So that it looked nice, and then tie it on this side. And then I have this little piece and I put it in here, but it's not gonna fit properly, and that's just that water cannot come in here. So now we push this to the middle. So I hope that is waterproof now. And this 2 tie wraps, I place them so that I'm gonna show it that when this is here in the middle, like this, between those tie wraps, then it's always on the same place. See? So that's important, that this is the same as this one. This is the idea. I tear it 2, and then so maybe this is not necessary, but it can always wiggle a bit, you see, like this, and with a duct tape on it, it's steady. The last tie rip. So. And now this one. See, when he is coming on the water, then maybe this will go too far like this, and that, you know, you see, it's not very steady. So I take this and put it in here, and then in there. Maybe one is enough. I think one is enough.
The big moment. Is he floating? Yes. He floats. But can he fly? Is it not too heavy? And there is a bit of wind today, so he flies a bit nervous. Because he's catching more wind because of all that material, of course. But he cannot sink, so that's why we made it.